Have you always wanted to look like this, this, and this? And have you always looked like a crap load of this, this, and this? Today, your only solution, only God, your only goddess, your only teacher is me.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel. If you are new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. I know, right? Like, who is she? Who is she? Like, it's been a ride. Like, it's been literally 5 years that I had braces, and it feels very, very weird, like, not having them. Like, I had my braces twice. Like, first time I had it for 2.5 years, and second time I had them for like 1.5, 2 years. So they have literally become a part of me, and it looks so weird without them. I feel like, you know, something is missing. Like, I gave my farewell to my braces. I'm like, you know what, this is the last time we are going to meet. Just don't let me come to you again, okay? Please, like, I don't want to go through the pain and suffer again. So yeah, these are my teeth. I am pretty happy with the result. Actually, you know what, this is not about braces. Let's get into the video. So today I wanted to do a flashback video. So today I wanted to do a video for like that flash photography. Like, there's no flashback, you have that very flawless skin. Listen, if you are getting some flashback, or you're having some issues with anything you're using, or you're just not able to make anything work, it's okay. You know, I've been there. I've looked like a ghost a number of times until, you know, I figured out how not to look like a ghost. So anyway, this is like a full glam, my go-to glam for a night out. Like, I am a full glam person even in the day, but this is like that proper chiseled face, that with that whole, you know, contour, highlight, baking. So this is a whole process, and this is literally what I do every time I go out in the night, because nobody wants to have flashback and everybody wants to look flawless, all right? And this, there's no heavy eye makeup involved in this. I keep it very basic. You know, if I have to do it very quickly and I have to head out somewhere, I basically just concentrate on my skin. So yeah, let's get started. Now let's talk about ingredients in a foundation or any product which are not supposed to be used during flash photography. So anything with SPF, or any, like, you know, anything related to or the ingredients which, you know, involved in making these two, please absolutely stay away from them. Like, if you don't want to have flashback, then, you know, let it be 1%, 0.0001% of SPF. You just stay away from it, or else you're going to look like a white ghost with a gray cast. See, as people with a lighter skin tone, like, you know, people 3 to 4 shades lighter than my skin tone can get away with a lot of things. But once you start, you know, coming in category of my skin tone, it gets really, really tricky. When you're lighter and you use something light, it's still going to look like your skin tone. But when you're brown and you're going to use something light, it is going to look weird, right? So you can use them during the daytime if you absolutely love the product, but during the night, if you don't want flashback at all, stay away from SPF. So first I'm going to start with my absolute favorite, Maybelline Superstay. This is my go-to foundation, guys. Then I'm taking this is the Vichy blender. My hormones are going so crazy. Like, look at this area. Like, you know, when my hormones are dancing inside my body, this part of my face breaks out like crazy. You can see, like, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 5 huge pimples all at the same time. Please don't get me wrong when I'm asking you to use product without SPF. I absolutely stand for using an SPF. But when you're doing, usually when this is like a makeup for a flash photography, and you usually use flash during the, you know, night time, right? So like during the night there's no sun, so you definitely don't need to apply SPF. But yeah, during the day you absolutely have to use SPF. So now my foundation is laid down. Now let's move on to the concealer. Now this is like a very important part, like usually because people get flashback, you know, a full glam people, if someone is doing some mistake, they usually get flashback under the eyes, like when they apply a lot of concealer. That is because, see, first of all, it could be the, you know, fault of the powder, but even if it's not the fault of the powder, the second reason could be like they're going too light, like, you know, they're going 5-6 shades lighter than the skin tone to make it, you, to get that very bright and highlighted look. And I get it, like, you know, it's a choice to look very snatched or, you know, very highlighted. But when you come under a certain skin category, like I am in that medium to deep skin category. So when you come in that category, you need to be really, you know, picky about the few things, because when you go very light, there's a tendency that is going to look very gray in the pictures or very white in the pictures, which is not so pleasing. Like if you like it that way, it's fine, but if you don't, I would just, you know, always recommend to use a concealer which is just two to three shades lighter than your skin tone. So this is the LA Girl concealer in medium beige. So I'm just going, this is like literally 1.5 shade lighter to my skin tone, so I just use that. You know what, I always forget to ask people to subscribe to my channel during the video, and I do it in the end, and I don't think anybody even sticks until the end to listen, you know, hear me say please subscribe to my channel, please ring the bell. So yeah, please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Now if I want a little more highlighted look, I just take a concealer which is tad bit lighter than this. So I'm going in with the Maybelline Age Rewind in Sand. This is just a little lighter. I'm just going to take this contour stick and apply. This is the KKW Beauty contour stick in dark one. Just take this and blend it up. I blend that into my hairline. So that's my contour laid down. Let's move on to the powders. Oh, I can literally write a whole book about powders, guys, because I've gone through such makeup disasters. Like, now it is funny, but absolute worst nightmares. Like I've used the best of powders, but still I always used to at least get a little, you know, even a minute flashback, which used to kind of bother me because I wanted to have that very blended base and not a white powder grayish base. So people rave about the Laura Mercier translucent powder. Like, I've not heard a makeup artist say bad things about this. I've used this. So, you know, when you hear so much good about a product and then it doesn't work, you start blaming yourself that you're not doing it right. But I've tried to use this powder in absolutely always. But it just, like, you know, even if it is 0.0001%, it still leaves a little bit. Now I would not say this was an absolutely amazing powder, but for my skin tone, I feel it still leaves a little bit of white cast. So the only solution for a brown skin girl to not get a flashback is to use a colored powder, and Maybelline blessed us all with this absolutely amazing powder, Fit Me powder. This is just like a a powder god, like the god of all powders. Like, it's so affordable. That's the reason I'm saying they have absolutely more fantastic powders in the market, but this is the best powder, like, you know, in the affordable range. You know, if you can't afford, see, MAC powders are amazing, like the MAC Mineral Studio Fix powders and all, they're absolutely amazing. So if you're someone who can afford it, you can easily, you know, blindly go buy those things because they won't leave any flashback. But if you want something, a loose powder on a budget, so Maybelline is the powder. What I do, see, I have the shade medium, all right? So what I do is sometimes I mix the translucent powder and the Laura Mercier translucent and the Maybelline Fit Me just for my under eyes, because see, the medium powder is like my skin tone. So when I apply the same color powder under my eyes, it kind of removes all the brightening effect I gave to my skin. So if you don't like such kind of thing, you can absolutely go in with the powder directly, or I just mix it both and then apply it under the eyes and just apply the medium all over my face. And so I'm just mixing the two together just for my under eyes, because I just want it to be a little more bright. And you can, if you want like that, you can even absolutely buy two powders, one light, one medium, because it's so affordable. But if you already have a translucent powder at home, you can totally do this. So I'm just mixing the Maybelline Fit Me and the translucent powder, so it has come into this light shade. So this gives a very nice effect for my under eyes, and then I'm just going to use the medium for the rest of my eyes. So I'm just going to take the beauty blender and then see that there are no creases before setting it. And I first lightly dust the powder all over my eyes and then I go in with the baking. So I'm just like, if you wanna try, you can do this with a translucent powder alone as well. Like, I used to make it work, like I just used to take the tiniest bit and just dust it so just that this concealer is set, and then I used to go with a larger amount, like a larger portion of the powder, and then bake. Because the first time, if you're going to go with like a heavy handed and apply a lot of powder, you know, on that, when you're going to dust it off, it's going to grab onto that powder, like, and it's going to have that white cast. So just dust the powder first onto your face and then you can go in with the baking. Now I'm done with my under eyes, so I'm just going to take the Maybelline medium and set all over my face. I usually don't get flashback with the translucent powder when I'm applying on the face. It's just the parts of the concealer, because the concealer kind of grabs onto the powder a little stronger than I guess a foundation does. So I just get that a little flashback with the translucent powder on the areas where I apply concealer. So I just do this. Now let's go in with the contour powder. This is the KKW contour powder in the shade contour 6. I'm going to put a flash tested picture in the end of the video. Love doing nose contour because I have one big potato nose. So for the eyes, I really don't do much. If I am not in the mood, I just take the bronzer and I just apply it on my eyelids as well. I really like, you know, a bronzed look any given day. Go on to the baking. So I'm going to take that mixture powder and I'm going to bake my face. I absolutely love the way, you know, baking can just give that chiseled look. I love baking my nose because it even gets quite a bit oily, and you know, this makes it stay the whole day. Like, if I do my makeup stays still for 24 hours for sure. Like, the days I go out in the night and, like, you know, I'm at my friends, I don't sleep, I come back in the morning, or even if I sometimes just pass out, if you know what I mean, I wake up and my lashes are also intact. Like, not a bit of my makeup ever moves. My friends are always shocked, you know, did you just do your makeup again? That type of thing. Now the Laura Mercier powder is a little drying for dry skin, so it kind but then the Maybelline one is really good. I mix both. There's one more reason as well. Yes, this is too dry, this is, you know, gives a very nice finish. So when I mix both, I don't feel too drying as well, so it leaves, like, you know, a very balanced matte. So after this, I just usually do my eyebrows, eyelash, eyeliner, eye makeup or anything. And I just wrap it up. So I'll just do that and then we'll be back. I'm back. So off camera, what I did is I used these Glomier, I don't know how to pronounce these lashes in Divine. Absolutely beautiful. I always wear lashes when I'm going out in the night. And of course, a night out or a night glam is not complete without red lips. So I use this Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink in Pioneer. Stays on for literally your whole life if you're not going to remove them. And then I use this Nude Cosmetics liner. This is a precision liner. Absolutely love this too. So it's been around like, you know, 7-8 minutes or 10 minutes. So now it's time to kick off the bake. So you need to make sure you get in and get all that powder thoroughly. Because if you're going to, you know, just leave a few pecks, like it's going to look again ashy and powdery and it's going to give you a flashback. So just be very sure and just sweep your powder brush and make sure you get all the powder off your face. This is the Pack 261 brush. A lot of people ask me, is, you know, is setting spray really necessary? Like if you're someone who does makeup for the sake of it, you know, just does it upar se, it's fine. But if you're someone who does it like a full glam, like foundation, powder, contour, baking and all that stuff, like setting spray is so mandatory because it just melts all your makeup together. It locks it in place. It lifts all the powder. Like, you know, it just melts the powder. It doesn't leave that very cakey or powdery feel on your face. And like the MAC, oh, they're right there. I can't. The MAC Prevent Prime is like the all-time favorite, but I'm running out of it. Like I ordered one and it will be, you know, delivered today only. But until then, I'm using this Urban Decay All Nighter. This is one of the great setting spray. Just again, I take that sponge. I just, you know, press all that setting spray into my face and it even, you know, lifts off if there's any excess powder or anything. So I'm just going to take the Nykaa 24 K Glam one, warm gold and pure gold. So I'm just going to take this highlighter and go in. Just want to add a little shimmer on my lids. I'm going to take the ColourPop Super Shock Shadow in Lady Bird. So yeah, that is the look complete, guys. I'll insert a picture with the flash photography. Like I'll just go into a dark room, take a flash photography and upload a picture somewhere. So random, guys, but I just thought I'll do check-ins. This is it's currently 7:20 now. You can see, please focus. So it's currently 7:29 now and I've had this makeup since 2 o'clock. So I just wanted to show you guys that can't talk. So I just wanted to show you guys that my makeup stays on put like for a very long time. I'm probably going to be up for the whole night. I'm going out with friends tonight. So I just changed my outfit. I just wore another top. I wore a red bodysuit. I wore a jacket because I'll be going in the metro. Just added a neck piece. I got it from Shein. So yeah, it's currently 7:20 and I'll check with you guys in some time. Okay guys, it's 9:50 now. Makeup has been on for like 7-8 hours. The lashes are intact. The highlight is good. So yeah.
Proof ji padta photo attend meet. Oh no, the record is
Hare this guy's. You go in front. And yeah, that's it for the look. This is literally my go-to glam look. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you don't look like a ghost or a devil anymore. Or you don't suffer with flashback. And yeah, that's it for today's video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Ring the notification bell so you get notified every time I post. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.